place before you even played a single note. The lights and the volume and the movement. It must be an incredible rush for you to be there at the core of all that energy, especially the energy that comes back to you from the audience.
Yeah, well, depends on where you play.
Of course, I mean, every place has its own feeling, so to speak. But I'm sure that some things remain the same wherever you are. Take girls, for example. There are always the girls at the edge of the stage jumping up and down, just waiting for a chance to grab a foot, a leg, or, well, whatever.
Yeah, there's a lot of girls around most of the time.
But honestly, though, you must find it kind of annoying.
No. Well, I don't know. I mean, one beat him up really bad and one beat him up real bad.
Are you serious? Whatever for? For someone who's so loud on stage, you're awfully quiet. But speaking about your performance, about, well, your technique, so to speak, how on earth did it originate?
How did what originate?
Your act. You know, the way you always move him around. You hold him, you carry him, you drag him along by his hair. Where does it all come from?
It's like life and newspapers. Like life and newspapers. And it's about life. About living. It's sick. It's very sick. It's about where we live. You know?
That makes me think of something else. The total lack of concern for anything. I mean, wouldn't you say that that is the essence of punk? Look, I made a list here. Like the safety pins, the writhing spastic movements, the ripped clothing, and the names of the bands, i.e. the Dead Boys, Suicide, the Sex Pistols, and of course their lyrics. And then a couple of your titles like Live Rat and a Dead Man's Hat.
Cat's Mouth.
What?
Live Rat and a Dead Cat's Mouth.
Right, right, right. But why? Where on earth did you ever think of such a thing?
I was pissing at the time.
Are you serious?
Are you serious?
I had to piss real bad. It was after a set. So I went out back in the alley. And there at my feet, in the light of the street, was a live rat in a dead cat's mouth.
My God, you really saw it?
I tried to piss on it, but it was too quick for me.
And with that image, you went home and wrote the tune?
Home. I went back inside, and I told Dickie, and we wrote it before the next set.
That's truly genius. You know, you're really good. You really are. And a lot more people are going to think so, too, by the time this article comes out. To be honest with you, I think you're going to be famous. Would you like to be famous?
Yeah, I'd like to be famous and make a lot of money so I could buy things like maybe a jet.
And you don't want anything? What do your parents think of you being punk rockers?
Who cares?
Precisely. I know what you mean. For me to leave. I'm meeting a friend uptown in about half an hour. It's really been a lot of fun talking to you, and I'd love to have asked you a lot more questions. Maybe we could do it some other time.
Why don't you come by after the show?
Oh, I'd like to. I'll try my hardest, but no promises though.
Ta-ta. What do you think?
About what?
About being in the magazine, being famous.
Famous? Sure. Why not?
Yeah, I think I'll send a couple of copies to my mom and dad. Think she'll come?
I don't know.
Elvis. Do you fucking believe it, man? Do you fucking believe it?
Now or never, my love.